Academy of Science. The night will come when the Academy of Science itself will not disdain to cast its gaze upon the sewers of the world. The night will come when, covered in all their jewels, the secondary skeletons that one calls scientists will ask themselves this question.
What do little girls dream of who want to take the veil?
It will remember, above all, a certain night, because...
Latin.
She wrote rather playful phrases in which we reveal Tenebrose.
Your kiss seems adult, my child. Coming from God, it will go far. Come, my daughter, go ahead and count on me.
My costume seems indecent.
Had given her because of her lively, alert, and playful character. because of the large crowns of red vapor she generally wore around her hips and ankles. Her real name was Marceline Marie. This double first name is of prime importance in the evolution of the dream which follows, because it is probably due to the troubles provoked by the coupling of the two names of such a different signification that we will see her slit herself up the middle of the back from the very beginning of the dream and wear the appearances of two distinct but closely related persons.
Where are you?
Papa, papa.
Tell me, who am I? Me or my sister? Or down there, that dainty Santa was on in her little private desert.
Oh, wonder,
here come the leech chimers. Let's go, let's dance the tenebrous until the beautiful dancers are completely exhausted.
Thank you.
we've come to the bandage hour.
We offer you, O Lord, the bandage.
Religious this point, Marceline Marie awakens and examines her clothes, which she finds decent. Sisters, she told herself in dreaming, and called one of them
Marceline,
and the other
Marie,
or
I,
and
my sister.
Perhaps it should be pointed out that during the whole dream, she only rarely succeeded in identifying in a definite way with one of them, and only at these happy moments did she see herself as she generally appeared, with her real age, her real sex, dressed and combed as usual. Marceline Marie coming out of the anthropophagus tree.
Upsy-daisy, upsy-daisy.
Beneath the boy's soul's door.
her heart from the day of her tooth loss, virginity loss, first communion, came to her at age 11 during the benediction of a statue in bronze of the little saint of Lisieux.
Thank you.
Marceline Marie wakes up and checks her clothes. After pulling down her nightgown, which has slid up above her knees, she goes back to sleep. Stupefied, the seminarists stopped their singing.
My child!
Replied the Reverend Father Denis de Lactisle from the height of the altar.
You have, yes, you have, a religious vocation. You must accept what has been offered you.
Even though you're only 11 years old.
How grateful you must be to Mary, your well-beloved mother and patron. It is she, never doubt, who has done everything.
Before, during, and after.
The knife.
The dream continues.
Hey, little ones, where were you?
Was condemned to pay a fine. She paid the fine, but only after improvising a scene in which the punishment inflicted by the Mother Superior was rendered ridiculous. She sang until midnight the wine of consolations, a monotonous chant of penitence sung upon a single repeated note, and rose afterwards to bite the nails of all her sleeping.
Yeah.
Thank you. Especially bad taste.
Certainly, I always charge too much. The palaces, not the hovels. I'm going now, and I leave you my anger. Digestible if you haven't eaten.